Hello everyone, welcome back to the NABARD Grade A question series, and this is day 4. We have also launched our NABARD Grade A and Grade B comprehensive courses, which are available for 15,000 and 11,000. Along with this, the paper 3 for NABARD Grade B is available for 5,300, and the NABARD Grade A and Grade B, the ARD statistics and phase 1 mock tests are available for 5,700. These are the gross prices. You can avail discount on these courses with the code NABARD20, NABARD, NABARD in caps with 20. You can get 20% discount on these courses. Now let's begin with the very first question. The first question is, which of the following is also known as riverine soil? Very easy question. The answer is alluvial soil for this. First of all, the reason behind alluvial being called the riverine, because what happens is they flow from the fertile land and get deposited by the rivers or stream. Therefore, this soil is known as riverine soil. Another feature of alluvial soil, and the question was even asked in the last previous year question paper, that which is the most abundant available soil in India. So it's the most abundant or most easily available soil in India. That is approximately 43% to 45% of land in India is covered with the alluvial soil. Again, next feature of alluvial soil is that it's available in the Indus Ganga Brahmaputra plain. So if a question comes regarding the soil which is available on these plains, then the answer would be alluvial soil. Now there are two categories of alluvial soil, the first one being the khadar and the second one being the bhangar. So the new alluvial soil is known as khadar and the old one is known as bhangar. This is very, very important to remember. These two are the categories, or we could say these are the two types of soil which is found in India. Now there are four things which you need to know about the alluvial soil. The first one being the color. Next is the texture, the minerals in which this soil is rich in, and it is deficient in which minerals. So the color of the alluvial soil is light gray to ash gray. Very important. So the texture of the alluvial soil is sandy to clay. The nutrients in which this alluvial soil is rich in, potassium or potash to be very accurate. So potash is the mineral in which it is rich in. Next, it is poor in phosphorus. So if we look at these features of the alluvial soil, then which are the crops which could be grown in the alluvial soil? For that, you need to mention your answer in the comment section. Simultaneously participate with me so that you can retain on the every information which is being provided. Next is, which of the following is the common soil cations? Now this is very important, as there was one question being asked last year. First of all, before discussing about the common soil cations, we need to understand what exactly are the cations, or what exactly is the cations exchange capacity of the soil. So cations basically means that how much or how many cations, the positively charged ions, could be retained by the soil. That is what the cation exchange capacity of the soil means. You do not need to go into the science of this cations, but what important in this aspect of cations exchange capacity is that how the cations exchange capacity of the soil affects the pH level, and how it affects the fertility, how it affects the water retaining capacity, and how ultimately affects the crop. So if we look at the pH scale, so below 6 we consider it as acidic, and above 6 we consider it as basic. So this means that here the hydrogen ions are more, but the pH level is less. So higher the number of hydrogen ions, lesser is the pH level, and less the concentration of hydrogen in the soil, the more is the pH level. So this is how we determine the pH level with the hydrogen ion capacity of the soil. So which are the commonly available cations in the soil, and you must remember about this. So calcium, magnesium, potassium, ammonium, hydrogen, sodium, these are the commonly available cations in the soil. These are the positively charged ions, and so these are cations are the positively charged and anions are the negatively charged ions. What are the common anions which are found out in the soil? So it's chlorine, nitrate, sulfate, phosphate. These are available, the commonly available anions in the soil. So if we go back to the question, which of the following is the common soil cations? So calcium is the common soil cation, the sulfate, chlorine, phosphate and nitrate, these are the anions which are available in the soil. Now, how does the cations in the soil affect the fertility of the soil? So, if we increase the pH level, that means we are reducing the number of hydrogen ions present in the soil and we are going towards being the basic. So, increasing the pH level actually increases the cation exchange capacity of the soil. And better the cation exchange capacity of the soil, better the soil and fertility. Better the soil and fertility, better the water retaining capacity. So this is how the cation exchange capacity, the chemical component of soil is very important. Next question is, which of the following soils have the highest cation exchange capacity? Now this question is directly related to the cation exchange capacity. The higher the cation exchange capacity, the better is the water retaining capacity. Or we could study it other way around as well. We could study the nutrients which are present in the soil. Thus we can answer the question. So highest cation exchange capacity. So the soil which should have highest cation exchange capacity, it should have nutrients which have the better cations in the soil. So if the soil contains either calcium, magnesium, potassium, ammonium, hydrogen and sodium in a better quantity, then the soil is better at cation exchange capacity. So if we look at these options, then black soil is one of the soils which is rich in calcium, potassium, aluminium, magnesium, iron, and at the same time it is poor in nitrogen and phosphorus. Thus it becomes the highest cation exchange, or it has the highest cation exchange capacity as compared to the other soils. Apart from having the highest cation exchange capacity, what are the different features, other features of black soil? So other features of black soil are, it has the highest water retaining capacity as well. So not only the highest cation exchange capacity, but the highest water retaining capacity is in the black soil. Now there comes another question related to the black soil, that why the color of the black soil is black in physical appearance. So for that you need to mention in the comment that which nutrients are present in the black soil that makes it black in color. So mention that in the comment section below. Moving on to the next question. So choose the most inappropriate option. First is, soils with low cation exchange capacity are more likely to develop deficiency of potassium. This is absolutely correct, because potassium is some of the commonly available cations, and if there is a low cation exchange capacity, then there would be deficiency of potassium in the or other cations in the soil. Pure sand has very low cation exchange capacity. That is absolutely correct. The sand has low water retaining capacity and therefore low cation exchange capacity. Clay soil has very low cation exchange capacity. This is incorrect. Why is this incorrect? Because clay soil has high water retaining, or it has high cation exchange capacity. The example of this is black soil. Why? Because black soil is clay in nature. Along with this, it has high water retaining capacity and high cation exchange capacity as well. The last question is, which of the following is not a physical characteristic of soil? So physical characteristic represents something we could feel or we can see with the naked eye. So soil structure could be seen with the eye, soil texture can be seen, soil permeability can be seen, but the soil pH level cannot be determined by just seeing the soil. Soil's density can also be determined with the help of eyes. So soil pH is the chemical property or the chemical characteristics of the soil. And what are the other physical characteristics? So the depth of the soil, the organisms which are present in the soil, these are the physical characteristics. Coming to the chemical characteristics, so the acidity, that is the pH level of the soil, the cation exchange capacity of the soil, the salt level, the nutrients present, these all can be just studied, or these are the chemical properties of the soil. So do mention your answers in the comment section below for the black soil and the alluvial soil. And do not forget to subscribe to our channel, and the links for buying the course is already available in the description box. Thank you so much for watching the video.